Now, the
Yes.
proposal, General Banac, for the IAS to be removed from the umbrella of the PNP, make it a separate, independent body to really make it an effective organization to go after erring cops. What do you think of this? What is the position of the PNP on this?
Well, the PNP thinks that the proposal needs further study, and it may not be unnecessary at all. However, we respect the position, and
it may not be
you know, separated from the PNP.
It may not be necessary to
separate
it. Yes,
may not be necessary. But we respect the opinion of the Internal Affairs Service, and if it comes to that, then we'd have to just obey whatever that will be decided upon. But as of now, we feel that the Internal Affairs Service has already been given enough independence. We respect that, and we help them a lot in the development of their organization and in their processes. But if we will be asked if we can present another option, we'd rather suggest that Internal Affairs Service would come under the NAPOLCOM, because we belong to one family. And,
so if they are to really separate the IAS from the PNP, better to place it directly under the NAPOLCOM?
Yes, at least we still belong to one family, and coordination and then preparations of this undertaking would not be very difficult. But
because I think the question is, can you have PNP men investigating their own?
Oh, yes.
Given the brotherhood nature within the organization.
Oh, yes. It is expected that the Internal Affairs Service is supposed to do that. And we feel comfortable that they are with us, you know, for so long a time that Internal Affairs Service is there, serving as our watchdog. And we find no problem at all. It just happened that this thing has been, you know, given so much attention. That's why it is being discussed.
Okay.
But as we've said, it needs further discussion.
Attorney Casuro, that was one of the options made public, the possibility of putting the IAS under the NAPOLCOM. Would that be a good move?
A very welcome move. Because right now, the independence that they're trying to figure out will be realized if they come under the auspices of the National Police Commission. Why? Because even by law and even by the Constitution, the National Police Commission manages and supervises the PNP. Now, if the Internal Affairs Service comes to the umbrella of the National Police Commission, there is not much thing to be done anymore, because it's just a matter of restructuring it. On the other hand, if you go really independent and attach your unit to another body, that will require some legislative intervention. With NAPOLCOM, you get the independence that you want in terms of your adjudication powers, in terms of your budget, for instance. This can be addressed already if you are within the auspices of the National Police Commission.
But what will be the role of the IAS under NAPOLCOM?
It's going to bolster the law enforcement functions of the NAPOLCOM, because right now, the law enforcement functions of the National Police Commission is only being undertaken by one division of the NAPOLCOM. And it's very insufficient. If you would like to address the entire concerns of the Philippine National Police, but with IAS bolstering this particular division of the National Police Commission, it will spell a lot of difference and enhancement.
General Banac, in essence, because there's a lot of criticism when it comes to the effectivity or effectiveness of the IAS as it is now, it investigates erring policemen, mm-hmm. but ultimately the decision will be course through the PNP chief,
right.
And then you have another appellate body available at the NAPOLCOM.
Yes.
How effective or ineffective actually has the IAS been?
Well, on the part of the PNP, we think that it is effective, and we have dismissed a lot of PNP personnel already for the past 3 years. In fact, more than 2,800 of them have already been dismissed and undertaken by the Internal Affairs Service and approved by the chief of the PNP. And insofar as internal discipline, a total of 9,172 cops have been meted with disciplinary sanctions ranging from this suspension, demotion in rank, and forfeiture of salaries. Yes, we think that it is effective, but of course we respect the opinion of the Internal Affairs Service. They may have their own opinion also and justification.
But technically, can the PNP chief impose those sanctions without getting the EAS on board on his own? Or commanders?
Oh, yes, yes.
They can do that, right?
The commanders of the...
up to a certain degree of sanction.
But when if you talk about dismissal...
If it's dismissal, it goes to the appellate mechanism. It goes to the National Police Commission for review.
How about the proposal that perhaps it's also better to place the EAS directly under the DILG?
Well, it's synonymous. Actually, it's the same.
It's
if
the
you
same.
Put it until under the National Police Commission, that puts EAS also under the DILG.
Because the chairman is the...
The chairman of the National Police Commission is the secretary himself.
Mm-hmm.
So it creates the same effect. So I think it shortens everything. But there is another proposal to put it under the Office of the President. That would be a very ideal situation also.
Why?
Well, because the independence, as I was saying, that they are longing for, the budgetary requirements, the personal complement that they want to realize, can easily be addressed because it's the Office of the President that can, you know, arrange all these things for them.
But in essence, there's really a need to strengthen the ES to make it more effective.
Yes, in terms of so many things. Personal complement, equipment, technology. You have to put in a lot of all these ingredients to make ES really a very formidable group to watch over the PNP.
Now,